Hello everybody, we're going to talk today about Finland and take a close virtual trip around it, and you'll see facts about it, amazing facts, and you'll see the politics of it, the economy, the culture, the geography, the history, and you'll find it amazing. And we'll start it by watching a time lapse of Helsinki, the capital of Finland, and then we'll talk about history. I hope you like the video, and now we're going to talk about Finland's amazing history, which includes a lot of amazing facts. And according to historical evidence, the area now comprising Finland was settled at the latest around 8500 BC. During the Stone Age, Finland was conquered by many other empires, the Swedish Empire in the 12th century and by the Russian Empire in the 19th century, where they conquered Finland by defeating them in the Finnish War. In the 20th century, there were civil wars that were declaring Finland's independence from the Soviet Union, until Finland finally gained its independence on 1920, determined by the Treaty of Tartu. During the Second World War, Finland attacked the Soviet Union twice, in the Winter War and the Continuation War. And now, in recent history, Finland changed its currency from the Finnish marka to the euro, which the euro was their official currency in 2002. And now we'll see a short video about Finland when it was in World War, and then we'll talk about Finland's geography, and I hope you like the video. I hope you liked the video about the Finlands when they were fighting in the World War. And now we'll talk about geography, which you will like a lot. It has amazing facts about Finland. And now we'll start geography. Finland lies between 59 degrees and 71 degrees north and longitude 20 degrees and 32 degrees east. Finland is a country of a lot of lakes, which it has 187,888 lakes. For that, it's known for the land of lakes. Its largest lake is the Saima. It's the fourth largest in Europe. A lot of geography in Finland is explained by the Ice Age. The glaciers were thicker and last longer in the Finlandia compared to the rest of Europe. Their consumed effects have left the Finnish landscape mostly flat with few hills and fewer mountains. Its highest point is Haiti, and its height is 1,324 meters. It's found in the extreme north of Lapland, at the border between Finland and Norway. There are at least 60 native mammalian species, 248 breeding bird species, over 70 fish species, and 11 reptile and frog species present today. The widely recognized mammals found in Finland are the grey wolf, elk and wolverine, and the brown bear, or as it's called, the national animal of Finland. And the birds there, the upper swan, which is called the national bird of Finland. And Finland has a humid and cool semi-continental climate, which is characterized by warm summers and freezing winters. And now we'll watch a short video on which is showing the four seasons of Finland, and then we'll talk about Finland's politics, and I hope you'll like the video. I hope you liked the video of the four seasons of Finland, which showed the nature of Finland there and which showed the power of God, how to change from snow to the sun, which is really the beauty of the nature. And now we'll talk about Finland's politics. The Constitution of Finland defines that Finland is a parliamentary democracy and the Prime Minister is the country's most powerful politician. The president is considered a ceremonial figure but non-executive position. And the current president is Sauli Niinistö. And the parliament there contains 200 members. And it's exercised by the supreme legislative authority. And the parliament is elected for a term of 4 years. using the hat method, and the speaker is currently Eero Heinäluoma from the Social Democrats Party, and the current Prime Minister is Jyrki Katainen from the National Coalition Party. And Finland has been a member of the European Union since 1995, as represented in the European Parliament. And now we'll watch a short video about the significance of the Parliament in Finland, and then we'll talk about Finland's economy.
As a little boy, I learned that in Finland, it's up to us to decide what game to play and to agree on the rules. What's fair? What's right? What's wrong? How can we get along with one another and with ourselves? We're all interested. How can we put our views into practice? It would be difficult for all of us to get together each time decisions need to be made. So we've delegated power to representatives. We elect them every 4 years. Of course I vote, but I also keep an eye on my MP between elections. We only have one vote with which to influence the outcome of the election. I've become more interested in politics, and I think I understand it much better these days. Parliament is Finland's main political arena. It provides a framework for representative democracy. Parliament deals with people's rights and obligations. This means making laws, deciding on the state budget, international agreements, EU matters, and overseeing the government's actions. True democracy means that a country has an effective government that is subject to oversight and an alert opposition that monitors its doings and offers alternatives. In a parliamentary system, the government must enjoy Parliament's confidence.
I hope you liked the video of the significance of the Parliament in Finland. And now we'll talk about Finland's economy. Finland's main sources of revenue are metal industry, which includes shipbuilding, metalworking, and the car industry, engineered products such as motors and electronics. And by the way, Nokia has a lot of big factories in Finland, which it has the most factories in Finland. And also, Finland's main sources of revenue are forest industry, which includes forestry, timber, pulp, and paper. Finland's energy, 18% of it is run by nuclear reactors. Also, the rest of it is used by hydropower and wood energy. And Finland's currency before joining the European Union was the Finnish marka, and now it became the euro from 2002. And there's an amazing fact about Finland, that there, if you travel to Finland, you can't use the 1 and 2 euro cents there, because they aren't used there. And now we'll watch a short video about the shipbuilding there in Finland and the shipyards, and then we'll talk about Finland's culture, and I hope you like the video.
A small country, big shipyard. Very important, yes. To the economy, let's say that Turku shipyard directly gives work for about 20,000 people around these premises here.
We are preparing the inclination test for Saturday. And
very often people think that shipbuilding is cutting steel. Altogether, steel proportion is less than 10%. Many things are done outside the shipyard grounds, and then they are installed either on the shipyard or on board. Very complex thing. For instance, the Allure designs, we had, I think, 32 engineering companies in Europe working to engineer the ship. We have had close to 1,000 subcontractors, partners to put the things together. We orchestrate the whole thing, do less by ourselves, much more with our partners, and of course in a great cooperation with our customer. We are very happy to work with Royal Caribbean, who focuses on creating new things for the customers. We are very much of the same kind of a company.
Please raise the house flag of Royal Caribbean International.
We have a long and mature relationship with them. Our people and their people know each other extremely well. Everybody knows what they're meant to be doing, whether it's during the construction process or on board the ship at sea trial. And it all comes off the way the script says.
It's like small boys' dream. All small boys like to build big ships. Working with the world's biggest cruise vessels, it's very rewarding. Working with big challenges to create something new, create new innovations for people. I enjoy my life and my work very much.
I hope you liked the video of the building of the ship and the shipyards there in Finland. And now we'll talk about Finland's culture, and it will be a lot amazing than the other facts about Finland. 77.2% of Finland are members of the Lutheran Church of Finland, and 20.1% have no religious affiliation, and 1.1% belong to the Finnish Orthodox Church and other Protestants denomination, and Roman Catholic Church, and Muslim and Jewish are 1.5%. Finnish and Swedish are the official languages of Finland, and the current population of Finland now is 5,400,000. And Finns have made major contributions to handicrafts and industrial designs. Finnish architecture is famous around the world. And Finland's most international successful TV shows is backpacking travel documentary television series, Mad Ventures and the Dudesons. And most of Finland's music is influenced by traditional Karelian melodies and lyrics. And there are a lot of popular sporting events in Finland. Pasapallo, it's a reminiscent of baseball and it's the national sport of Finland. And Finland also participated in a lot of most of the Olympics, and Finland hosted the Olympics in 1952. And now we're going to talk about Finland's touristic options. Leinamäki Amusement Park. Leinamäki is the most popular amusement park in Finland and has the biggest selection of rides in Northern Europe. The sounds and smells are the highlight of the summer for 1 million visitors each year. And the Suminelna Maritime Fortress. Suminelna is one of the 7 UNESCO World Heritage Sites in Finland. The ferry ride itself is a fun experience, allowing you to see and photograph Helsinki from the sea. Suminelna attracts visitors of all ages with its bastion walls, cannons, tunnels, museums, restaurants, and more. Attenum Art Museum. Attenum represents the largest collection of art in Finland, including famous Finnish paintings by Albert Edelfelt, Axeli Gallen, Kallela, and Helen Skiffersbeck. Helsinki Zoo. It's one of the oldest zoos in the world. The zoo presents over 200 animal species, from the Arctic tundra to the tropical rainforests. Kuri Kasseri also participates in the work to protect the habitats in the original homes of the various species. The Natural History Museum. The History of Life exhibition presents the development of living organisms from the Big Bang to dinosaurs, and from giant mammals to the Ice Age. The interactive exhibits invite visitors to discover the astonishing diversity of nature. And the churches. Over 150 years old, Helsinki Cathedral is arguably Finland's most iconic and photographed building. And the Siirosaari Open Air Museum. Siirosaari is a popular museum island that shows how Finns lived from the 1600s to the 1900s, and the beautiful walking paths around the island are popular all year round. And now we'll watch a short video about Finland's culture, and then we'll conclude all the facts we knew about Finland, and we'll reflect on it and what we've learned, and I hope you like the video.
Finland in 73 seconds. Cultural aspects. Finland is situated in the far north of Europe, in Scandinavia, well, not really Scandinavia, the Nordic area, but anyway, right about here. The national hobby is sitting in a room throwing water on hot stones. And now for some famous Finnish design you might recognize. The Aalto vase, the Marimekko patterns, the Mobira, haven't you got something more modern? Oh, wait a minute. You might have one of these in your pocket. Do a Google search on famous Finns, and Formula One champion Mika Häkkinen would come out on top. Mika himself was unavailable, but this guy sort of looks like him. Okay, let's press on. Heavy metal, Finlandia vodka, Esa-Pekka Salonen, reindeer, Sibelius, Moomin, and Santa Claus. Wait a minute, the popular Santa Claus is actually the invention of some bottling company.
So?
Well?
I will still get paid for this, right?
Think of it as a gift. Somewhere in among all these things, you'll find us. Oh yes, and we're active globally.
I hope you liked the video about Finland's culture. And today we learned many things about Finland. Like that it's famous for architecture and handicrafts, and you can't use 1 and 2 cents there, and that it was conquered by the Soviet Union and it's ruled by a parliamentary system, etc. And my final reflections of Finland, that it doesn't have a stable weather and it's not crowded or has pollution in the air, because the growth and it has of the lakes there, because it has many lakes, as we knew that it was called the land of many lakes, and Finland is the most democratic country in the world, and it's really advanced in technology because they became to use nuclear reactors in energy, and their forestry industry increased the export and production and trade rate, also the metal industry. Also that there it will be not easy to talk English because it's not much spreaded, and there was there as Finnish and Swedish languages are the official languages there, and English is not that much there. And thank you for watching, and I hope you learned from these facts as I learned, and I hope you like my video, and we want to meet in my next video. And thank you very much.